Hey guys, what's up? Today, I'm super excited to share this with you guys. Yes, we're talking about Swift for Windows, but it's so much more than that. Even if you own a Mac, if you've ever struggled with learning Swift programming, then this is also for you, so please watch carefully. Last week, I got an email from the University of Southern California, Viterbi School of Engineering, and it said, "Hi Chris, I work with Professor Bunyatin, the advanced iOS instructor at the USC Viterbi School. We came across your name while researching the top online blogs and educators of the Swift programming language. Professor Bunyatin has built this tool, which I've blurred out because I want to reveal it to you guys later in this video, which he uses in his courses to show the working code of serverless Swift. It's similar to JS Fiddle. We would love to get your feedback on it. Are you available for a quick demo? Thanks in advance for your time, Hamlet." I checked out the tool, I got really, really excited, and I immediately replied yes. Now, before I take you on the tour of this awesome tool, let me ask you one thing. Are you subscribed to my channel? If yes, then thank you so much. But if not, then please consider subscribing to support and encourage me to produce more videos for you guys. All right, now let's dive in. So launch your browser and in the address bar, type in play.swiftengine.io. And then launch your favorite YouTube series for learning Swift, just like the playlist I've got here, link in the description. Before you get started though, let me show you a couple of tips. The first thing I want to draw your attention to is this run button up here. When you click on that, what's going to happen is it's going to take the Swift code you write in this code window, it's going to send it as a request to the Swift engine, it's going to process that Swift code, generate the output, and send it back to your browser in this section right here on the right hand side as a response. Now, the next thing I want to draw your attention to is this new button. You can click that at any time to start a new code window, and basically just clears everything that you've written here. Let's start by using a preloaded example from this dropdown here. Now, some of you who have seen Swift code before might notice that it looks a little strange because of these tags here. I'm referring to these angle brackets and percentage symbols. Now, what's happening here is it's just encapsulating the actual Swift code to send as a request across the wire to the Swift engine. Now, luckily, they've provided us with an option that we can write Swift code without including those tags. And this is going to be super crucial for beginners learning Swift because you don't want to have to worry about these extra tags and where they go. So if you click that, that's not going to change what you've written so far, but whenever you start a new SE Fiddle, you can make sure that that is checked, and then you can just ignore any of that tag stuff and just write your Swift code. So for example, let's write that, and then we go ahead and click run, and you're going to see the output on the right hand side right here. Now let's do another example. Let's declare a variable. And actually, let me show you what an error would look like. So for example, if I did something like this and I tried to run it, and you're going to get an error message telling you what's wrong with your Swift code. So that's really helpful as well. It says that we're missing a space there. And let's declare a loop that's going to go 10 times. And I'm just going to add one to it in each of the loops, and then I'm going to print A. And we're going to get the result right there. Now, another thing I want to draw your attention to is now we have the share button as soon as you've written some code in the window. So what's cool with that is you're going to get a link to share this code snippet that you've written here. So anybody who visits this link is going to be able to see the code that you wrote, and they're going to be able to run it and test it out as well. Cool, right? The thing that excites me the most is how accessible SE Fiddle makes it to practice Swift, especially for beginners or people who are using a Windows PC. This tool is going to be a game changer for how you're going to see content from me too. For example, if I show you a snippet of code in my video, I can pop it into SE Fiddle, get a share link, and put it in my video description. So if you want to just copy my code and paste it into my Xcode window, you can do that. And if I issue an iOS challenge, which reminds me it's about time, you guys can submit your code with a share link to an SE Fiddle where I can run your solution and see that it actually works. In the past, people have shown me screenshots of their code as code submissions for the challenges, but with SE Fiddle, it's going to be so much better. Finally, for the lessons on my site, I can embed a code window below the lesson for you guys to actually try and type out the code.
Come on, admit it. Half of you guys just watch the videos and call it a day, right? Right? Oh, it's just me? But seriously, guys, if you really want to learn this Swift programming stuff, you really have to practice it and make mistakes. Now I'm going to give you 4 actionable steps to learn Swift on Windows or Mac.
Step 1. Visit my Learn Swift playlist, link in the description. Click on Lesson 1 and watch it. Step 2. Launch SE Fiddle in another browser window. Step 3. After I run some code in my Xcode project, do the same in your SE Fiddle window. Step 4.
And guys, that's it. There's no secret to it. You just have to do it. Go through all of the lessons in the playlist like this. And remember, if you're having trouble remembering certain Swift keywords or syntax structures, that's perfectly natural. What might help is grabbing the Swift cheat sheet, link in the description below, printing it out and having it beside you. Now, one word of warning though, don't try to memorize the Swift keywords because that's not really going to help. You might remember it if you try to memorize it, but you'll lose the context of when to use it and why you're using it. Instead, count on repetition to help your fingers remember what to type in context of what you're trying to accomplish. And speaking of which, next week I'm going to reveal my special technique for learning Swift fast without memorization, and I call it the CH method. So if you're not subscribed to my channel, make sure you are subscribed so you don't miss this special technique. SE Fiddle will be perfect for implementing this technique. So I want you to know that SE Fiddle is still in active development. So if you find any bugs or glitches, or if you have any feedback, just let me know. And I'll let my main man Hamlet know, and he can transfer that to the dev team so that they can work on it. All right, now I want to turn it over to you, and I want you to be very, very honest with yourself. Have you learned Swift before, but you didn't actually practice it and type it out? Let me know by typing yes or no in the comment section below. Finally, if you learned something new today, please subscribe to my channel. You wouldn't want to miss the CH method, would you? All right, I'll see you guys next time. Bye.